Hello from Farland. I've been on a journey. Sickness, fevers, more sickness. But I seem to be recovering, although I can't say that I'm 100% yet. I haven't done that much work. I've done some. I get tired really easy. Got two lights, platform lights installed. I got one of the station buildings lighted up. Few people in there, we can see it later. I was able to pick up a restaurant car for my olive green southern rake. The only first class in the rake is the brake, and I was able to order a new, a second coach, all first class today. So I'm excited for that to come in. Let's move somewhere else. Question was asked, how am I building these platforms? Well, I want to be as precise as I can so that we have a realistic gap. This is the widest coach I have that I want to run. And so I just wanted to be sure that it would run easily along there. I'm using something that's not very bright, is it? It'll have to do. I'm using something called finger jointed pine in the U.S. And it is 7/16 inch thick, or 0.69, don't know how many millimeters that is. And I space it up 7/32 off the board, which is about 0.23 inches. You have to lay your track very straight. And then I measure from the bead of the rail and make sure my platform is 1/2 inch over from. I actually planned this so that I could use a full board here, which I don't know how wide that is, but I think it's about 35 scale feet or so. But it wouldn't have to be the width of this. You could certainly rip these down to any width you wanted. I just felt like making it the full width. And once you space it up, then you have to put the edging on. And the way I make my edging is with this. And these are, that's basswood, and those are 1/8 by 1/4 inch strips. And there's three vertical strips, 1, 2, 3, and then one on the top for the edging. And that sets along in there, like that. And I set it at a height. This all works out because this height is exactly the right height so that when I put this paper on there, it's flush. So that it's absolutely even across there. This is the Metcalf brick paper. It's a fairly nice card. And then you can, whatever treatment you want on this. Over here, I just painted it black and I put verticals on it. I'm not going to do that on these two. I'm using brick this time. And I'm going to get the airbrush out and I'm going to darken it up. I'm going to darken it to the point that you could just barely make out that it's brick. Now for the top, you probably noticed these black lines across there. Those are where, when I was cutting these cards, I made a mark where the join was going to be. And then I came back and I painted it black. That was so that when you put two cards together, you don't have an absolutely perfect joint, it's just black. Which works. And that's how I make my platforms. I think over there on the black one, I used 1/16 by 1/8 inch pieces that I cut and glued all the way down. But I'm not going to do that on these, on this new one. I did that already. So that's how I make my platform. Right or wrong, that's how I make it. And this extension is just so that this turnout is has a little extra room there. And I'm going to do something over here to give this turnout a little extra room too. And I don't know what. If this is a problem down here, I will just trim out the edge until it's free. When I get done, and if there's not quite enough room to get those coaches on there, I get my plane out. And I run my plane down all the way along, taking very fine cuts, super fine cuts, but taking them all the way along the edge. You've seen my block plane before. I keep the blade very, very, very sharp. And I just put it down there and set it on the track and run it down. I think I shaved the top of this a little bit. I shaved the outside a hair, and I shaved a little bit off the inside of this side. So in that case, it was letting it ride along the rail and just running it all the way from one end to another, because you've got to have, you don't want any, you know, jags and jogs along the edge. So a very super fine cut, just a bare shave, but then multiple times until you get it just right. One thing I haven't decided yet is whether I'm going to use this scale model scenery edging. You cut it out in the strip and then you glue it there, and it gives you the platform piece, and it goes underneath a little ways. Or is it this way? Nope, it's this way. I would probably trim this bottom off a little bit because I wouldn't want it to lap up on the brick. But I haven't decided yet. I did that over on Farmore, and it worked pretty good. I had to cut out each individual piece, though, over there. It wasn't so cool. That's how I make my platforms. This will have a ramp, and there'll be fencing here to keep people from falling off and all that. Just a note, with all this stuff running at the same time, the Z21 is drawing 3/4 of an amp. Not bad. We'll hang out here at the junction for a while. next week. I'll see if I can think of something truly exciting. See you then. Bye for now. Bye from Farland.